back in Scottsdale, Arizona, Aubrey wanted to show me something.
That's new. I haven't seen that before.
The promise of more time has fascinated man from the beginning, always beckoning. More time for love. More time to experience life to the fullest. More time to see what the future will bring.
This is where you come when you're dead, if you have enough money and want to be frozen in liquid nitrogen until science finds a way to bring you back to life. Aubrey's an Alcor consultant, so when or if his time comes, they'll freeze him for free.
Come on in. Alcor's operating room. This is actually the second stage of the procedure in a cryonics operation. The first stage occurs in the field at the patient's bedside. Prior to pronouncement, setup is done, and then at the moment of pronouncement, an Alcor team takes over. Open heart surgery is done, a bypass operation to remove the blood and replace with something called a cryoprotectant. The point of this is to remove as much of the water as possible from the body to prevent freezing damage during the descent to liquid nitrogen temperatures. The intent is to preserve people at low temperatures until such time as the process can be reversed, whatever killed them can be cured, and they can be restored to health and released into society.
Well, you're smiling, is that because?
Because I think it's kind of cool. This is Alcor's patient care facility. This is where the patients are actually stored in giant stainless steel tanks called dewars. Alcor has 75 patients, all of which are stored in this room. Each one of these tanks holds up to anywhere from 9 patients, 4 whole bodies, 5 neuros, up to 45 neuro patients.
What's a neuro patient?
A neuro patient is a head-only preservation at this point in time, where the procedure itself focuses on preserving the brain directly and not the rest of the organs. The intent is to protect the personality and the identity more so than the rest of the body.
Is that cheaper than the whole body?
A neuropreservation is cheaper, yes.
So, Aubrey, this is where you're headed for?
I hope not. Antonia hopes not. But it's better than being buried or burnt.
Are you seriously telling me that you're going to have your head frozen in the hope that sometime in the future you'll be able to be Aubrey de Grey again?
That's not quite what I'm telling you. What I'm telling you is that if, in however long it's going to be, I get to the point where I seem to be likely to die quite soon, then I would prefer to be cryopreserved in that hope, in the hope that I will eventually be revived, than to be buried or cremated and thereby remove any possibility that I would be revived.
What's going to happen to your body?
If I am still signed up as a neuro patient at the time that I'm cryopreserved, if I am cryopreserved, then my body gets disposed of. What may be more interesting is the question of how I'm going to get a new body. And that is an interesting question. It's something that's certainly beyond the abilities of medical science as we stand, but in however long it's going to be, I don't think it's at all far-fetched to suppose that we will be able to grow a body without a head, a body without a brain, and just sort of basically attach the revived head that was stored.
Imagine Aubrey's head on a new body. I wonder if he'd keep the beard. And another thing, with centuries ahead of him and aging cured, what would Aubrey do next? And what next after that? With all the time in the world, would even the most brilliant mind keep on discovering new interests and coming up with new ideas?